So yes, you were talking about Final Fantasy X.
Yeah, but I'm done talking about FF10 because I don't actually like that game.
Aww. Which Final Fantasies do you like?
4, 5, 7, 10, 2, 2,
Wow.
9. Oh yeah, 9 as well. I like 2 as a historical artifact because it's an extremely important game. Also, I like soccer games.
I mean, that would do it.
But yeah, I don't know. We've talked about my issues with FF10's general like plotting and cosmology before.
It's fun. Fun if you just don't do any of the bullshit mini games.
The other thing that poisoned my playthrough, my opinion of 10, is that my first playthrough, I ran afoul of how the sphere grid having any degree of openness for a new or first-time player is basically a lie.
Yeah, that's 100% accurate.
Because, like, I tried to, like, take people through additional paths, and the game is super designed around, like, you are at this boss fight, and you should have this exact ability.
Yeah, it's vaguely like exactly what they did with Final Fantasy 13, in my opinion.
Yeah, except
Where.
FF13 had the good sense to, like, basically show exactly how much it expected you to have at any given time. The Crystarium will arbitrarily unlock more nodes once you've reached another
I was
chapter.
going to say, it's not arbitrary at all. It's like, you are exactly here, so now you will have exactly this.
It's arbitrary within the narrative.
Fair enough.
Okay, yeah, B actually just said, hey, it's how we can work, start without me.
Ugh.
But yeah, and I mean, there's a bunch of those that, like, I wish I liked more. Certainly, I wish I liked it.
I wish I liked more is such a weird video gamey thing to say.
It's hardly like there's a lot of things that, like, a lot of kinds of media where it's like this is doing interesting things, but I think it executes poorly, so I don't enjoy it.
Oh, I think you gotta shoot yourself off that slope part there above that door.
There's always a slope part that I'm missing.
It's
Wait, that's how you got
always
up
a
there in the first
Eeyore.
place.
Where's that slope? Nope, missing it.
It's right above the door, Bob.
The
I understand the tone, though.
Right above the. Oh, okay, that part is a slope. Okay. It really didn't look like a. Like, I think I have problems with, like, three dimensions or something.
You got some sort of depth perception issue going on.
This is a tricky game for that kind of thing, honestly.
Oh
So
yeah,
sad.
100%. It's an extremely 3D game.
A joke about now you're thinking with portals, but yeah, you kind of have to.
Yeah. It was another one that I really wanted to like, but that was also because that was one that I got for Christmas. So it's like, oh, it would feel rude to not enjoy this.
Oh, that is, I've mentioned on the stream before, but that was hybrid heaven for me, which I
I
got as
like
a.
Hybrid Heaven, but that's mostly because Hybrid Heaven is dumb as shit.
There is definitely that.
Yeah, I think I got FF8 and Grandia the same Christmas, and I was baffled at how much more I enjoyed Grandia. Which
Oh, I
did
got
not stop
Final
me.
Fantasy.
Okay.
Yeah. I was gonna say I got Final Fantasy VIII for my birthday, since that came out in September that year, and my birthday's in September, so it's like, yeah.
Either that or a Dreamcast.
It wasn't bigger than the Dreamcast then.
Yeah, that's fair. I ended up playing the shit out of both Grandia and FFA, but I sure enjoyed playing the shit out of Grandia a lot more.
I had a good time with A, but I also had the Expert Gamer walkthrough, and that was a really good walkthrough.
Oh yeah, I had like the official strategy guide, and like that was okay-ish, but it missed a lot of explaining how the fuck anything actually worked.
I mean, I definitely, whatever strategy guide I had was big into like boosting guardians. Like that was its main technique.
Like I'm convinced that they did not fully understand good ways to get magic, and therefore did not have advice on how to do that instead.
Yes. Yeah, that is.
So, like the advice is always, well, get boost immediately.
Yeah, it's like summon like hell.
And it's like, yeah, like if I have like my biggest issues with FFA, whenever I try to replay it, it's just that. It's a game that, like, on some level, like, it's not a game's job to force you to play it well, but it's so hard to determine how to play FFA in a fun way just by doing what it tells you to do. Like, a lot of the things that it's rewarding you for doing are bad habits that you shouldn't
do. Like playing card games.
I mean, the card game is, like, if you like the card game is a great move.
I was going to say, the card game is the best part of the game.
Like, I don't like the card game, which is the other reason that I can't play that game. Because, like, if you're not going to play the card game, there's, like, not a good way to get spells.
That is one. I mean, you can just stand around and, like, stare at a monster until
it gives
you what you need.
That does not count as good.
And then, so you go to the islands on the edges of the map and grind those.
Yeah, the island closest to heaven and the island closest to hell, yeah.
Which, can I just say that is a name that, like, sticks in my head for the rest of forever? And it's just a place where you go to grind in a Final Fantasy game.
Yeah, no, I remember.
Like, that is the best name for anything ever.
It's a good one.
I think the undersea research facility was better for grinding in that one, but... It's been so long, and I don't remember very well.
The research facility is even later in the game, though.
Oh, yeah.
I think you can get to the islands when it's just Balam Garden, whereas I think the research facility requires the Ragnarok in that one. I think it's the Ragnarok.
Yeah. You're not going to get any more blueprint, Bob, so...
Oh, I thought that was the point. My bad.
You will not be shepherding blue paint across this area.
Fine. Go back up and figure out what I'm supposed to do.
I started playing a really stupid old game recently. Well, not that stupid, but a really stupid choice of an old game recently.
Go on.
I started playing the first Legend of Heroes game.
That's a choice.
Dragon Slayer, the Legend of Heroes.
Oh, the first one.
Yeah, when I said first, I meant first.
Yeah, you did.
But yeah, the Turbo CD version of that, which is the only version we got, even though it came out on everything. But I mean, it's a good version, and it's a surprisingly forward-thinking game given its vintage. But I've got hung up on the rafters.
Hey, found it. Good job.
I made it through the thing.
Yeah, that's a game that, like, I'm not used to an RPG of that vintage that has a... I forget what the orange gel does.
The frictionless.
Oh, yeah.
Make you go fast.
Yeah. But... It's rare to play an RPG of that vintage that is that forgiving when you die.
Yeah. Like, I mean, you're not wrong.
Because you have, like, Dragon Quest, where you die and it sets you back to town, and you have half your money, but you keep all your stuff. And like that's usually the nicest that an RPG of that vintage is going to be. In Legend of Heroes, one on the Turbo CD, when you die, you lose nothing, and it gives you the option to either restart the battle exactly with the exact health and magic that you had when you started it, or to be warped to the last town you were in with one HP.
Well, that's not too bad.
Yeah, like it makes it a lot easier to just go out and explore places, because there is basically nothing that can happen to you that you need to be that concerned about dying from. It's not a perfect system. There are absolutely places where what the game thinks is a town can fuck you. Sometimes you'll go to a place that's a town, but it's been overrun by monsters as part of the plot. But it's still a town, so you can be transported back there.
That ends poorly.
But encounters are visible on the map as well. So if you're bullheaded enough, you can always get back to some place where you can actually heal. Yeah, for a game from 1989, it also has, like, a protagonist who talks and has motivations. They're very simple motivations, but they exist. And a party with interpersonal conflict. You know, simple interpersonal conflict, but, again, 1989.
The best you could hope for.
And, you know, they're all charming. Like, also the voice acting is extremely funny sometimes. Because it is not badly acted, but it is from the period where the idea of what constituted video game voice acting was that the game, how you characterized a character was you gave them a really silly accent, so one of them sounds like a fucking New York private eye for some reason.
Oh, giving them a really funny accent. Never heard of that before.
Yeah. No, this was not a working design scheme.
I was thinking Chrono Cross again.
Oh god, no, that's not a funny accent, that's a Hamish accent. But yeah, they also have more personality than Chrono Cross characters. Yeah, no, I've been honestly impressed at it. Like, it is a game that I am enjoying, even outside of being interested in its historical context. And it does make me a little sad that there is no translation of any version of Legend of Heroes 2. It's the only game in the series, other than the ones that are currently in the process of being translated, that has never been translated in any fashion.
That sucks.
It's mostly just weird. It's like this, like, it's also the start of, like, Legend of Heroes games are released in sets, and Legend of Heroes 1 and 2 are a set. Like, it's the story sequel to the first one, which is also historically interesting. Play as the son of the first game's protagonist, and the first game's protagonist is, I believe, actually a party member, which is interesting. Oh, that worked great.
I'm figuring stuff out.
What we're learning from this is that GLaDOS isn't being mean enough.
We're trying.
And you just gotta put the blue gel there.
Yeah. Wait a minute. That isn't right.
White gel on top, and then the portal, and shoot the blue gel down.
Yeah, I know, I'm getting it. Just staring at it like, why didn't this work? knew that floor grating would be the greatest invention known to man? Oops, that's not what I wanted to do, but it was funny to watch.
What other stupid shit was I doing? Oh yeah. I decided to play Shining Force alongside its oft-forgotten GBA remake.
Well, there you go.
It's pretty good.
Speaking of which, at some point in my life, I will, like, actually play the, was it GBA or DS that had the awful Lunar games?
Yes. The bad Lunar.
The bad Lunar.
Because there's Dragon Song, which is an awful unique Lunar game. And then there's Lunar Legend, which is a very pointless video game. Lunar Legend is weird, though, because it incorporates some, like, very minor details that were seemingly canonized from, like, a light novel adaptation.
Of course. Why
so
would that
give
be
certain
the case?
Characters like names or last names that did not have them before? And it's also compressed in a very strange fashion. So, like, the inciting incident is Nash entering the open town. Why, yes, I did play all four versions of Lunar one after the other.
Why?
I wanted to see how they were different.
I have to ask that question myself.
People have done it on the internet. You can just read about it.
I don't trust them. This entire nonsense started when I did the even more, like, batshit choice of... I played Lunar 1 on Sega CD and PlayStation 1. In tandem, so when I finished a dungeon in one, I had to immediately play it again in the other. Which you would think would drive you insane, because you would think they would be very similar. Problem is, the dungeon designs in Sega CD Lunar 1 are fucking horrible.
Yeah, I love Lunar 1 on Sega CD, but it's not a good game.
It's one of those things where, like, it's very funny to look at, from the perspective that I had, because I only had the TS1 version growing up. I've never had a Sega CD for obvious reasons.
Because it's all...
Those reasons are called money.
I was going to say, yeah, I had the Sega CD version growing up, so...
Yeah.
But fun fact, Lunar 1 was the first RPG I ever beat, so...
Oh,
wow. Yeah, like, I think it's a really interesting version. And I, like, among all the versions that are not the PS1 version, I would say that it's the most interesting to play, even though it's bad. Just because it's the most different. Because, like, you get the GBA, Legend or Harmony, and those are just watered-down versions of the PS1 version. And, God, Harmony is such a, like... Legend has an excuse, because it's, like, you know, it was a compromised GBA port. Harmony has no excuse. I don't know what the fuck they were doing with that version.
PSP jankiness, yeah.
It's not even just the PSP jankiness. They imported in some of the jankiness the GBA version had.
Imported in.
Because the GBA version had these, like, limit breaks that all the characters get, and those activate, like, once every five or so turns. And some of them are ridiculous. I think Mia's is the most ridiculous. I believe that makes everyone invincible to all damage for three full turns.
Jeez.
And it's just like, there is very little excuse to ever die in that game just because of that.
I'm just thinking about it, because I remember how, when I fought Galleon at the Magic Emperor Galleon at the end of Lunar One on Sega CD. He pretty much one-shotted everybody except Alex. So I just had Alex just using his heal and then attack three times in his turn.
Yeah, Alex is ridiculous in the Sega CD version.
Yeah.
But like, he's strong in the PS1 version. He outclasses everyone at everything.
He's got magic, he's got healing.
I was about to say, I feel like he's the only one that's like viable as like a character. The rest of them are like, you know, I can do one thing and not all that well.
Because he's the Dragon Quest hero. Like, he has that, like, design. Oh, that's another thing that I was noting about Legend of Heroes' design, is that everyone is, like, to a degree as versatile as a Dragon Quest hero. Like, I think the protagonist has the best stats, but everyone is at least a somewhat capable fighter and a somewhat capable spellcaster. Which is interesting to see, especially because of the weird way the magic system works. Because everyone essentially has, like, a 7-slot spell book, and you find people that are like, oh yeah, you can copy my spell and get your spell book.
What am I supposed to be doing here?
I thought you were making a Pollock painting.
There's a joke about that I'll tell you after a stream, but no, what am I supposed to do?
Yeah, let's not do that. Alright, where were your guns pointing right now, Bob?
Uh-huh.
You're supposed to go up into that little area.
Oh, you can get... Yeah, but how do I make... Oh, no? How do I make a portal just so I can leave this area? I got nothing on that. Oh, never mind. Just do the floor. Duh. That'll probably get me killed. Okay, so... Okay. You just, like, you miss one spot and then it's like everything makes sense. Or the opposite of what I just said. Okay, back to talking about Lunar. Liquid movement in pipe.
Here comes Mr. Pipe.
Mm-hmm. You're supposed to shoot upwards the shaft, Bob.
I thought I did do that.
Well, from the orange, where you come out the orange portal.
Right. Like, no, is it nothing? Nothing's covered in paint here. We're disappointed in that. I feel like there should be something covered in white goop now.
super don't like that phrasing.
Not what I want. I think they kept me. No. Yeah, I give up. I'm going to quit now. Oh, God! Oh, my God, no! Wait, am I supposed to be here? No, this is the old spot, right? No? Where the hell am I? I don't even know anymore.
What an existential crisis that this game has presented you.
Did I? Yeah, no, I am back. How the hell did I even do that? Well, that's it. Stream's canceled. I'm pissed off.
Time for me to stream, I don't know, Gex.
Deep Cover Gecko.
I mean, that's the best of them.
The fact that that's even possible is annoying.
What's that?
I said the fact that that is even possible is annoying. Okay, let's...
Well, the fact that there's a best Gex is possible annoying.
That is what is terrible.
I mean, the tragedy of Gex is that, like, somehow the 3D ones are way better than the 2D ones.
The tragedy of Gex. Yeah, get some goop up there. Yeah, who knows? Oh no, is that gonna reset the whole... Everything.
He's a demon, aren't
we? We're not singing Speed Racer right now. That is a joyous song.
Maha go go, maha go go, maha go go go.
Blurp.
Bonk.
Okay. Can I just do this? Okay, I have that spot. Blop. Okay, so I at least don't have to do one of the puzzles all over again. Wait, how did I do that? How did I get here?
What's up, fuckers?
Not much.
I think I broke my brain playing Portal. It's disappointing.
It's not about Portal.
How are you, B?
Bad.
I'm sorry.
Now, I've been worse. I've also been better.
That's
just
neutral.
I mean, I wouldn't expect you to be feeling like the best you've ever been, just by virtue of the fact that, like, I imagine that's something like your wedding day or something. It would be weird for a normal Tuesday to have that energy.
Work has kicked into psycho overdrive, and I am psycho overdriving.
Psycho killer.
The very same.
Run, 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 run.
Okay.
Right,
that's what you're supposed to do.
What am I supposed to do?
Alright.
Just get up to the goo.
People don't like that term around here, but.
Get in the goo!
Alright, so go back to the hallway like we were before.
What would be the term for it then? The ooze? Nah, that's a Teenage Mutant Turtle shit. Right.
To your left, Bob. To your left.
I don't know what I'm doing, but I'm climbing a pipe or something.
We all believe in you, Bob.
That is confusing and not based on empirical evidence. I don't even know what's happening
here.
You're
close. You're close.
Okay. Is there, like, a Portal. There we go.
The most disorienting thing since the last time I watched the Descent long play.
Okay. Oof. I think I'm somewhere.
I think I liked the Descent, but I only played it like for 20 minutes in a computer lab.
Yeah, there's a chat you can make up there, Bob.
I can go even higher?
Oh, that was disorienting and painful.
Yeah, Descent was cool. It was just like an extremely disorienting game. Also, they used its engine for...
Alright, yay! You made it.
They used its engine for a D&D action RPG for some reason.
That's very bizarre.
Descent like, to Under Mountain.
Aren't you like basically just a tiny little airplane in Descent flying around the fucking air fence?
Basically.
Very bizarre.
But nevertheless, Descent to Under Mountain occurs.
Just a bitty bitty little fella.
But yeah, sorry it's not the greatest time.
It's fine. It's just work, you know. Work sometimes is very difficult. It is what tests us. This month has tested me more than usual, and my executive dysfunction kicked into high gear at the worst time.
That's not good.
Oh yeah, I know how that goes.
That's the shit. So, but I'm actually sitting at my work desk right now, and while I'm talking to you guys, I am opening things up that I didn't want to open and starting to read them. So that's good.
Congratulations.
Just like stop me if I start reading it out loud because it's probably confidential.
Yeah, I would recommend not doing that.
Somebody be ready to mute Beat if need be in his own Discord.
I think I've got those powers. We'll see.
Pretty sure you do.
Just to say. I got a new pair of Joy-Cons for my birthday for my brother.
And happy birthday! It's the end of the month, as predicted.
Right. It's technically not my birthday until Friday, so you can let hold.
No, we're doing this.
Birthday.
Yeah, we're not going to see it before then, so.
That's true. Also, I do have the capacity to mute Beats, so.
That's important.
That is fantastic.
Very important power to have.
I mean, I wouldn't want to not have it. I feel like it's very important for other people to be able to shut me up, even if it's just in a small, fake way. As I am very loud.
The universe has always failed in that hour.
I was about to say, you can't even shut yourself up in a small, fake way.
Okay.
Yeah, no, I figure I'll probably... I think I get paid on my birthday, so I might pick up Live Alive or something.
Oh,
excellent
choice.
Maybe don't pick up Live Alive.
Fair enough. Yet.
In that case, terrible choice. Why would you think of doing such a thing, fanboy?
Can't believe you never do that. Just can't honestly, deeply upsetting. Very, we are all very upset with you.
But no, it's just very generous to even come up with it, so thank you.
Yeah, if you can believe it, I actually pre-reserved Live Alive like the minute it was available at Target, because I figured like nobody else would be buying it and they'd probably have 7 copies. And it turns out it's weirdly popular.
I mean, those HD2D games from Team Asano have generally done about as well as anyone could have hoped for from them.
Bob, you can shoot above that door to your right there.
Oh, you can the gel pump door?
Well, I was going to say the one with the light over it.
Oh, okay. Is that where that...
Oh, God.
Oh, yeah, there we go. Well, that was convenient.
Oh, God. Did we all see what they're doing to Tactics Ogre?
Not on purpose.
I'm just going to have to live with that.
In fact, I went out of my way to avoid seeing it. This is knowledge that I just am better off without.
Is it official, or is it just...
It leaked from within the PSN.
So that's as official as it gets.
Yeah.
Like, it's not...
Maybe you'll be able to turn off the filter. We can hope.
that's awesome and hilarious. Tragic.
Okay, Now I can use
the nothing card. In the world better than ain't nothing in the world better than my company saying, but you really just don't want to be able to see the pixels, right? People hate pixels.
You just want it all smudged.
Yeah, we want it to look like you're trying to see it through a bottle of Vaseline that you just poured onto your eyes.
While you're screaming at the choice that you just made.
Hey, it all caps the beat there. That's nice.
I noticed that too. It's kind of amusing.
I appreciate that.
Oh, your paradoxes.
No AI can resist. The pumps are now functioning somewhere.
Well, you opened the hatch, so probably through the hatch.
That makes sense. GLaDOS's plan is so stupid.
Well, that makes sense, because GLaDOS is actually not as smart as she thinks.
She's kind of powered by a Wheatley, though.
I mean, that's not a high bar to clear.
Yeah, that's a very low bar to clear. Like, if your a point of pride is, oh, well, at least I'm smarter than the guy who is extremely dumb, and that is one personality trait.
The guy who was built to be dumb.
You're not doing awesomes. You're in trouble.
Where would loading be without elevators?
Much less diegetic.
Yeah.
It would have to be all cloud crawling through tight spaces. And specifically cloud in all games.
I love how in Mass Effect 3 they actually call back to the elevator conversations.
Remember a lot of time we spent in those elevators. For God's sake, your boxes. I have a shotgun. With legs. It's literally your only purpose. Walking onto buttons. How can you
not do the one thing you're designed for? Try to get us down there. I'll hit him with a barrel. Has the idiot made his grand reappearance?
I mean, just about here.
Alright, okay. That is a part that I feel like I need to pay attention to, because I like that part. That part is fun.
Oh, it's funny, because we've been at this for 12 hours, and you haven't solved it either, so I don't know why you're laughing. You've got 1 hour. Solve it.
Elevator travel apparently has its own little subtitle.
I realize that it is in the interest of accessibility. Accessibility tools are 100% good. Or hard of hearing or whatever. And just like for when like you're playing with the volume super low because you don't want to bother your like spouse or whatever. Right. Obviously.
Or having everyone on the string.
Oh. Or that even, right? But that said, man, I really wish they had just like instead of like writing elevator noises, they just wrote or like, you know, stupid onomatopoeias. That's fun. I like that.
They're fun, but they're probably
useless, and they are not helpful for anybody at all. But I just can't hate them, you know? I just can't.
Yeah, no, I'm just saying, like, they would be actively detrimental.
Oh, no, no, it would be spitting in the face of the entire point of what these are for. And off we go. Okay. But I just like them.
As long as we're on the same page.
No, like, if they actually did that, I'd be like, wow, that was a terrible choice. Every once in a while, I just want to see them make a terrible choice, you know?
The fun kind of terrible choice, as opposed
to exactly.
The terrible choice. Yeah.
The sort of, like, terrible choice I can point and laugh at.
You know, it must be hardwired into the system or something. Oh, but I'll tell you, when I do...
Oh, that doesn't work on Wheatley because he's so stupid.
Nothing feels better. It's
true.
Pointing and laughing. Did you guys see them, this week's crypto main character?
I'm trying to lay that stuff in again.
Boy.
Was it the person who invested in stablecoin?
No, it was
those
someone
guys,
who's like one of those like crypto investment
those,
guru like, gives advice.
Those, like guru advice master things, like giant war brain
god calculation master.
Yeah, exactly. One of those like, oh, I will tell you the secrets, and the secrets are all just, hey, if you think something's going up, invest in that. Don't do it.
Tremendous.
This investment advice should not be confused for investment advice.
Really good. Oh, here's an idea. Since making tests is so difficult, why don't you just keep solving this test?
One of those little tests run across the wall there.
Once you solve it. Yeah, that sounds much easier.
Just keep resolving this test.
Do it again.
Now do it again.
And... nothing. Alright, can't blame you for trying. Okay, new tests.
And yeah, it is hard to make tests, so...
I mean, that's kind of the joke. Like, it seems like it's so easy to be in charge, and the minute you are, it's like, uh-oh.
Turns out responsibility is actually quite difficult sometimes. Who would have guessed?
Yes. I think we've all been in that situation where it's like, oh, now I have to actually do this.
Oh, now it's this responsibility? I didn't sign up for that.
I didn't come here for that.
I mean, who among us has not been in a meeting where they're like, oh, that is the stupidest idea, this is how you should do it, and then suddenly you're in charge of that.
Oh, yeah.
Thankfully, I haven't had that experience.
It's, you're my...
Keep my head down and my mouth shut.
You're a corporate boy now, fanboy. You're gonna get. It's gonna happen, and it's gonna be like, what? You're gonna be like, this is so dumb.
And it will be so dumb.
Stop it! And it will be so dumb. It'll be the dumbest day of your life.
I've yet to be dumber than I am today.
Oh, there's always tomorrow. But
like
yeah,
said,
no.
Yet to.
That lady I wanted to drag for a little bit because I am a person with hate in my heart. It was just honestly kind of mind-blowing. I just want to stare at her. I just want to put her in a box and examine her.
I mean, the sad thing is there are likely people that are listening to her that rapt attention.
It's like, no, like...
Okay, a lot of the advice this time was like,
Robert, you
oh
the,
man,
the
what if you had a reward for
I'm breaking down crypto because it is a great, like basically college course on all this shit.
No, I have not.
Or for checking out, you know, whenever like you have the time or background silence to listen to 2.5 hours or something. But,
yeah, that's never.
Yeah, exactly. But point is,
background silence.
All these crypto guys desperately need you. Yes, you. You there, listening to me, to buy crypto. Because that way more money goes into the ecosystem, and that way they can cash out and get the actual money and go home.
Sounds about right, yes.
The longer-term goal is to make crypto an ineffable, unalienable, completely solid, completely unremovable part of life, like normal money. Like, we all hate capitalism in this call, I'm pretty sure.
Yes.
But,
yeah.
Like, we all also live in capitalism, and we'll probably be, like, you know, dealing with money.
We'll live and we'll die.
Right. It's just the thing. They are desperate for that to be the next thing that we will all live and die with.
Why didn't you go on ahead?
Yep.
Because that way, they'll be the ones who, like, had it before everyone else needed it, which means they'll be basically the god kings of the New World Order.
I mean, that's the thing that bothers me about every new Web3 announcement, because it all is like,
oh, fuck, it's stupid.
I was about to say, it's all so stupid, but you just know it's coming.
No, I honestly don't think most of it is coming.
Most of it is, in fact, not coming.
Raw consumer disinterest.
The raw consumer disinterest, because simple fact of the matter is, no matter how many celebrities they get to go on fucking Jimmy Fallon and talk about their Bored Ape, your average Joe just cannot give a shit.
But the thing of it is, I feel like it's a very optimistic outlook because I think of it as like before Facebook, there was LiveJournal and MySpace and etc. But then when it hit Facebook, like Facebook is never going away in some shape or form, whether it be Facebook or not. And I feel like
it's entirely possible crypto will be the future, but it certainly won't be the future in its current state.
Yes, no, I agree with that.
Current state, it is just a highly volatile speculative instrument for people to do two things, and that's buy child pornography and run their computer so high it burns their house down.
Yes, I cannot disagree with that.
So I'm gonna draw some other points into this. So like a lot of the ways that the attempts to quote-unquote Web3, like, you can tell that none of this is working because they keep trying to tag new names onto it. It's like, for 7 minutes there, it was the Metaverse, and, like, that went away. Web3 was, like, a branding attempt that hasn't really worked either. No one actually wants it.
Everyone hates Web3. I can't see a single person who isn't,
nobody
like,
really
trying
wants
to sell
it.
Something that likes
so,
Web3.
But, like, to put it another way, so, like, one of the things that I was thinking about today was, so Facebook announced that they are increasing the price of their VR headset.
Yes.
They are
$100.
It was $300 and now it will be $400.
And it's the exact same thing that came out
because they were probably selling those things at a loss in a desperate attempt to make MetaQuest happen. When MetaQuest just didn't fucking happen, they're like, oh shit, we are burning money.
I mean, it probably also has a lot to do with the fact that they like their share prices like fucking tanked. So they need to do things that...
Yeah, people still want to play with VR because VR is fucking cool, but like their goal of creating the future...
Of being the VR ecosystem is not...
The VR ecosystem is just not appearing at all, and they are like, and, oh shit, we'd better actually like make money on these things.
Yeah, so the broader thing I was going to say about that was that, and this is the thing that a lot of these people miserably fail to actually understand about what their market is and what they're competing with, is when I saw people reacting to this news, you could immediately tell the difference between someone who was in the tank and already loved VR and someone who didn't, because people who were in the tank and loved VR are like, oh man, well, I mean, that's, you know, it's more expensive, but, you know, it's still one of the cheaper solutions, it's still a good headset, whatever, and, you know, it's still one of the better options you can buy, and these people just are unwilling or unable to accept the idea of, like, you're not competing with the other headsets because that's still a very small market. You are competing with, fuck this.
Right.
And it's super easy to lose on a new technology, for a new technology to lose to, fuck this. And that is routinely what is happening with, like, crypto bullshit, is that, like, the choices are hope that I'm in, like, the right space in this Ponzi scheme, or fuck this. And because there's no use case for any of it from either a consumer or a corporate standpoint, fuck this keeps winning.
Oh, absolutely. The thing that blew my mind specifically about Idiot Girl, I keep throwing a hook into our neck and dragging us back to, is, and I think this is hilarious. I'm wrong. I'm like, you know, because I have hate in my mind. But the thing that blew my mind about her idiot thread of, oh, the future business on all these things, one of the things, one of the first ones was for Amazon. Amazon pay you in crypto, but it's really script, to have their warehouse in your backyard.
Yeah, that one was... I saw that, excuse me.
Fucking sense.
they will give you. They'll give you tokens to run Amazon, so that you have like a distribution spot, a hot spot in their backyard, so like the drivers can swing by and stuff. That's not really
that's even less efficient.
Yeah,
so that relies on them trusting you not to like deal or break shit.
Yeah, I mean like and like, but like here's the other part. Why's it gotta be crypto? The simple fact of the matter is, if I'm like renting my backyard, which I can't imagine that's
worth
much.
You could literally send you Amazon gift cards and it would make more sense.
Yeah, like why would I want crypto for that? Fuck you, pay me in money. All of the ones that all of her like use cases for crypto, money was just the easier option. Just fucking set up a direct deposit. Why it gotta be crypto?
Direct deposit, or like half the other ones are rewards programs.
But no, it has to be crypto because that's
what she's selling.
Set it on the wall to the right there.
Yeah, right. I was figuring it out. I got there.
In the fullness of time, gone up.
But yeah, like that's of course the inevitable problem with all of this. It's just that like no one has yet like. It remains a solution in search of a problem, and they're not looking that hard for the problem. They just want you to use the solution.
I could see a possible future where something similar to cryptocurrency is used as a like large-scale banking banking system.
Like an intermediary thing.
Like it's an intermediary, it's a go-between. That said, the entire...
Basically, you have to ban it from speculation or else you'd fuck yourself.
Yeah, like, there's literally no point in, like, doing any sort of spec... Like, it's completely useless as currency, which, you know, that's in the name, so they're fucking up pretty bad there.
I'm coming, don't start yet, don't start yet. You are not going to believe
this. Oh, there's a little tree frog on my window. That's cute.
I love tree frogs.
Tree frogs are great. But, like, in all these cases, like, fucking Axie Infinity. You hear about that shit?
Yeah,
that
thing was ridiculous.
They were for months. Years. They only lasted that year. Screaming that this could be your full-time job, and that's when Ronin does the blockchain. They were, goes to the moon, you'll all be rich. You'll be super glad that you did our stupid pay-to-earn scam. Play tour. But really pay to earn, because the cost of like just setting up that game is like $400. And the immediate thing was that people figured out, oh well, the best way to run this is not to, you know, just play the game normally like a game. The best way to do this is to pay to onboard like 15 people and take half their shit, and basically now you're a digital pit boss running a fucking video game like sweatshop.
Are you talking about Axiom or whatever?
I'm talking about Axiom. Hi, Kalskrum.
Good day and welcome.
And like the broader issue that was succinctly pointed out by that folding ideas was basically just that like it's impossible. Like nothing ever naturally goes into that economy because no one's playing that game for fun.
Yeah.
And so it's impossible for everyone to cash out.
And I would like to point out that I want to say also that any of those like pay-to-earn games that have ever been floated have been floated by people who have not played a video game with a community ever in their lives.
They just see it as like, here's a thing where a lot of people often spend a lot of money, so we can.
Yeah.
So
but no, I mean, even beyond that is the concept that if you've ever played like anything from, like, never mind like Fortnite or Halo or something where it's like deliberately competitive, if you've ever played like Pokemon with the community, you know that there are people who have turned like Zubats into Mewtwo killers because that's how people work.
Like, yeah, this is what we do.
And of course you also run into the fact that like they're relying on, oh, there's a giant ecosystem of players, surely they spend money. It's like anything like this, the majority of players do not spend money.
There's 1% of people who will spend money, and they are the entire fucking ecosystem. They are
people. Yep.
they're like
getting
the time,
getting that one big hook is worth the
on the time
players
they are which, just untreated gambling addicts,
which is why
you get people spending like millions of dollars on fucking Diablo.
And speaking of which, I saw somebody post about this, but you notice how like the word whale has been like banned anymore. Like, it used to be a very common thing that people talked about, and now the term, like...
Oh, yeah, no, they don't want to talk about that
because that term doesn't exist anymore.
That's, it lays bare
the
truth.
You're fighting people who have, like, a psychological problem.
Yeah, well, like, that's what they were... That's what's going on with, like, the video game stuff. But, like, the guys who don't, like, have a psychological problem, the guys are the ones who are, like, already, like, multimillionaires or billionaires trying to cash in on what they think will be the next big thing. It's they're basically gambling addicts. It's only those are the ones who know they're gambling. The ones who are, you know,
those are the ones who could reasonably, like, realistically never gamble enough money for it to matter.
Yeah, like, those are the ones. It's like, there was this great analogy about, you remember when fucking Bloomberg, like, ran the Democratic primaries?
Yeah, no, I remember.
Got American Samoa and that was it. great day for comedy. The thing about Bloomberg, though, is he is so rich, everything in his life is free. There is nothing he could buy.
He never has to worry about making
that actually
number
impact, like, the number in his bank account. Like, I call myself rich to you guys because my logic is I have a house, I have a car, and I have enough in the bank to fix the house and the car when they break. That's rich.
The normal
that
would
is
be
good
like
stuff.
Well off, I guess.
I go with rich because I feel it's like sort of, but exactly. So
my standard,
like,
for being well off is if you can go to the grocery store and not have to do the math in your head.
Exactly.
Yeah,
that's where I'm at. I could just go to the grocery store and say, all right, I guess I'll try this other brand today. It's like a dollar more, but whatever, right? Because I have enough money. And like, when I want to buy a video game, I just buy a video game. I don't think, oh, can I fit this into the budget? That is the level of wealth I have. Because accounting pays relatively well. Mike Bloomberg, everything in the world is that to him. He could go out and buy a fucking Lamborghini and it wouldn't, like, you know, make him bat an eye. He could buy a house and he wouldn't even have to worry about it. Everything is free to him. Everything is just whatever.
Yeah.
And he's not even, like, the richest motherfucker alive.
Yeah. It's just a high score table at that point. But,
it's like they're dropping right through it.
Yeah, like, what the... My depth perception is crap, but this is still seems bad.
No, like, I'm with you on this one. I'm looking at it, and I'm like, it looks like they're...
There we go.
It looks like...
Yeah, it seems like they're moving too fast, essentially, for them to be captured in the tractor beam. Oh, there you go.
Got to get there eventually.
I got that old Florida lag. Florida lag.
Hell yeah, mine's way behind, too.
Florida leg.
What was I talking about?
I get back
anyway, yeah, fuck crypto. Fuck NFTs. Fuck Bitcoin. Fuck you.
Fuck the rich, yeah.
Not you, Calspro. Because you did give me a Bitcoin and I threw it away.
It was a bit dying, but yes.
I have a tenth of a Bitcoin sitting on a USB somewhere in my house, I think. If I didn't
have you considered swallowing that on the
let's talk about that.
I remember reading that post with perfect clarity. I am not certain it was a shit post.
I remember it too.
It seems suspect. It's like one of those things where it's like just ever so slightly too hilarious. But I have long
very much in print the legend territory.
I have very much learned that you can't really just take that for granted because oftentimes, well, it just seems too hilarious is not actually a good indicator.
Yeah.
I used to just believe that, like, anything that, like, made me laugh had to be fake. I don't believe that. Just too much.
Don't Doesn't have to be, but they're decent odds.
Here we go. Here it comes.
It's just worth checking before you repeat it as fact.
Yeah. But like, yeah, no, but dude, literally, like, the way he described it, but like, he's a racist.
Yeah, extremely racist, man, obviously.
Extremely racist person. Is, you heard them, like, yelling, and was like, oh man, this is a bad neighborhood. What if they try to rob me? What if they, like, snatch the USB because I give it to them when they rob me, and they don't understand how much it's worth?
Mostly, I would just want to rob him just to beat him up.
I mean, yeah, like, no, like, robbing him is just doing the world a favor. So he swallows it, and then digests it, because he sat in a bathtub for a week, and it never came out. So presumably his stomach acid just destroyed it.
I mean, yeah, I don't really see most cheap USB sticks being able to withstand stomach acid.
But yeah, though, imagine just like...
I mean, if he was lucky, he might have successfully perforated at least some portion of his intestines.
Hooray!
Hooray!
If you want to line it up, there's the little pattern on the floor and the ceiling.
It's like, now I'm getting it.
Disappointed?
Oh, no.
The itch.
Now you're playing with power.
I do like the idea that it programmed into whatever is the thinking part of this thing is the itch to make tests happen.
I mean, that's how you convince an AI to do anything.
Just give it an itch.
So that last test, I mean, that's kind of what machine learning is. Like, your job is to do this. You seek out the things that make this done more effectively. What?
I'm glad that I died so I get to hear Fatty Fatty No Parents again.
Good job.
Wow, I am really far behind.
Remember when I hit that old F5 key.
Alright, so that last test was seriously disappointing. Apparently, being civil isn't motivating you, so let's try her way, alright, Fatty?
Didn't even notice there was a turret fatty. There.
Fatty Fatty No Parents? What?
What exactly is wrong with being adopted?
What's wrong with being adopted? Lack of parents?
For the record, you are adopted and that's terrible.
And also,
with me.
Nothing. But some of my best friends actually are orphans.
Also,
but
look at her, you moron. She's not fat.
I am not a moron! Just do the test. Just do the test.
I was like, GLaDOS's little, yeah, he's right. But we shouldn't say that.
Not a moron.
But yeah, no. Just the leap of logic. And the fact that, like, the people he was so terrified were about to rob him, like, came running to, like, see if he was okay when he started choking at that hugging in the garage. Because he just swallowed his USB stick. They were there to rob him. They were like, yo, this dude's, like, having some sort of attack or something. Are you alright? Do we need to call a hospital? Literally there to save his life.
But he couldn't get his Bitcoin back, so what was even the point of being alive?
All I wanted was that Bitcoin.
All I wanted was that fucking Bitcoin. But yeah, no, the example that the lady that, like, you bring it up, that I've wanted to get to this whole time, was to make an NFT of a diamond. And then you lose the diamonds. You still have the NFT. The NFT. Not lost.
Oh, yes. I saw your explanation of... Well, then what happens?
It's just like... So fucking stupid.
I do like the implication that this fool has based on nothing. That stealing the diamond would be easier than stealing the NFT.
Oh, yeah. Because NFTs have been stolen all the time.
They are the easiest thing to steal on planet Earth.
You're not wrong. Oh no, my box! Come back, box.
Listen, your box is busy.
I remember like seeing people post. Oh man, did anyone else jump into the furnace with the companion cube? because so the companion cube so emotionally moving. No, it wasn't. It was a fucking box. But the box had two little turrets just freaking the fuck out inside of it. I would have jumped into the furnace for that.
the turrets are characterized. The box is only as much as your individual attachment to objects.
I mean, I'm attached to certain objects. Who wants to be having a bad day? Anytime I've managed to misplace my wedding band.
Well, I can see why that would be the case.
How do you do that?
Because I assume he takes it off the shower or something.
I mean, I that was the kind of thing that I identified exactly what the problem would be when I first got one and made one spot in the house where it goes, and I never put it anywhere else.
Yeah, like, you know, that works in theory for people with functional brains, but here we are.
Yeah, like, here is the spot where it goes.
Understand.
I actually have a friend who, I'm not exaggerating, the third day of their honeymoon, he managed to throw his wedding ring into the ocean.
Oh, Lord.
Wow. And his wife is just like, okay, I know who I married. It's okay.
Like, my wife literally got my ring off of Wish.com for $5. Technically $2.50, so it came with one for her as well.
Nice.
Oh, yeah. Mm-hmm.
That's the way you do it.
He has since bought, like, you know, just a 5-pack of them, like, in bulk. Just keeps hidden somewhere for, like, when the inevitable happens, you can just hand me a new one and say, there you are, honey.
There you are. Wonder if she's, like, good enough to just exchange it without you even noticing that you'd lost it.
I am not attached to the specific ring. I'm attached to the
You're
idea.
Attached to the fact that it's a ring she gave you.
That's a ring that she yeah. gave me and that is on my hand. Like, you know, it doesn't necessarily have to be the very first ring I got, but it does have to be on my hand.
Makes sense to me. Is there... Nope. So... Oh, yeah. Just,
Stop. I imagine Chell is just, like, frantically trying to swim in the air every time she's one of these things. Just, like... flailing her arms as fast as she can to try and get any sort of momentum outside of the vortex.
I'll put you in the vortex.
Please don't put me in the vortex.
I would never put you in the vortex. It was a lie.
Thank you for not putting me in the vortex.
You're good people.
I didn't want to be in the vortex. Fuck the vortex. I hate the vortex.
The vortex.
I'd rather dislike the vortex. Please don't vortex me.
What was that? There was nothing! There was nothing!
The body he's floating in, my body, has a built-in euphoric response to testing. Eventually,
what if it turned out space was a big vortex, though?
Space is a big vortex.
I was about to say, I've seen the galaxy before. I'm pretty sure it is a big vortex. I like the admission that she was in it for the science. Deadly neurotoxin tells a different story.
I mean, I think she was in it also for the murder.
Don't mind me, just moving the old test chamber a little bit closer to me.
Pushpin and death. Love that.
Yes.
I am speaking about what I'm working on, but speaking in extremely vague terms. In this case, I'm happy because everything was all right. Don't ask me any specific questions, lest I break some sort of contract I probably signed.
Bless your little primate brain. I didn't realize one of these things was here.
Talking to me or Wally?
It's. I am repeating what was said. I'm just not good at lining things up today.
It's hard.
Same. In general.
Beat is a skeleton of the people.
I am.
Okay. They're all ready to go. Okay, so I can give myself a wall. That I kind of have to do. That doesn't... Oh, damn it.
Ow.
What's on the other side? Oh. Bollocks.
Bollocks, now that's a term I have not heard in some time.
I make a great deal of use of that.
Okay, I think I can maybe not die here. But odds aren't great.
Shoot up, Bob.
Oh, there's an up. Well, I'm dead now. Well, I'm dead now. Dig up, stupid. Take two.
Me, just moving the old test chamber a little bit closer to me. Okay. Maybe proximity to the test solving might give us stronger results. What was that? Oh, sorry, could have sworn you said something.
Got a box, that's good. Kind of. There's a hole on the other side there. Question is, how do I get past the thingy? Boop. Needed a slightly faster trigger finger there.
Hmm.
I'm glad this is all being recorded so like future generations can make up fun of how bad I am at this.
Don't mind me, just moving
Listen,
the old test chamber.
I have something to say. No future
current generations.
Yeah.
I was gonna say current generations are very funny.
I mean, I'm just always amazed anytime any of my the YouTube like upstreams like the entire world of Final Fantasy stream, like, it has like 6 views, and I am just amazed that it has 6 views.
Oh, I'm sure they clicked it by hand.
Oh.
Oh, yeah, I was thinking about, the, like, fucked up thing I was doing where I was playing Shining Force and its remake right next to each other. And the weirdest change is that the protagonist says things. He can talk now.
That is a change.
I was refilling my glass. Which protagonist?
No, the protagonist of Shining Force.
Oh, that's weird. That is weird.
So, like, yeah, in the Genesis version, he doesn't have a default name, and he doesn't say things. And in the GBA version, he has the default name of Max, and he has a voice.
I remember enjoying the GBA version quite a bit, but also not getting very far into it. I think it was mostly
it
just coasting
like
off.
It seems like a solid remake.
I was thinking it was, I would not be surprised if I was just coasting off of the good feelings I had for playing the original, not on the Genesis, but on the fucking Sega Smash pack.
Yeah, I was going to say, you probably played it on the Dreamcast.
Yeah. But Shining Force is a cool game, and I'm glad it's, glad it still exists. Well, does it still exist? Is this one of the dead do not trouble with living type deals?
Yeah.
So many Sega franchises that aren't Persona or Sonic.
There are Shining games.
They made them.
Yeah, and they are not typically Shining Force games. But yeah, I mean, you can still play Shining Force, certainly. It still shows
up
on collection.
It's very available.
Yeah. So, you know, have that Shining Force X if you don't play Shining Force X. It's just extreme levels of dog shit. I honestly would say the PS2 era is the worst era of the Shining series, and that's...
That makes sense. PS2 era was rough for a lot of, like, things that had been out for, like, that had been, like, you know, not around for a generation or so. So people were like, oh, we'll bring it back. And people were like, oh, that's exciting. And then it came back, and they were like,
oh.
I had a lot of fun looking up some of the more, like, obscure Shining games, like Shining Wisdom.
Is that just, like, a quiz game?
No, Shining Wisdom is a Zelda knockoff that sucks and is extremely ugly in the weirdest way possible.
It sounds like the Golden Axe game.
Like, Shining Wisdom, I love why it's so ugly, because, like, it's pre-rendered sprites, but it's as though you're playing a remake of a game you've never seen, a re-release of a game you've never played, because there's, like, really shitty pre-rendered sprites with, like, a horrible, like, black outline filter. And I don't know whose idea that aesthetic was, but it sucks. It sucks.
It was mine!
It wasn't. You would look at those sprites and be disgusted.
I probably would.
Let me pull up a Shining Wisdom screenshot. But Shining Wisdom's most interesting aspect is actually, to me personally, is that it has two different control schemes for running. And the game refers to them as semi-automatic and manual transmission.
That's actually really good. I can't not. I like that. On some basic
of course,
level.
The way that they work is nonsensical.
Oh no! I have no doubt that they managed to fuck it up somehow. But
so yeah, let me explain why they called it that. When you're trying to run in Shining Wisdom, you have to repeatedly hammer the button to go to like one of four possible run speeds. And if you're in semi-automatic transmission, that means that when you reach the speed you want, you can hold the run button and just stay at that speed. But in manual transmission, you just have to keep hammering the button at the right rhythm to stay at that speed for the entire game.
Why wouldn't you want to do that?
That is a very... That's a choice. That is several choices made in rapid succession.
But also, here's a screenshot of what Shining Wisdom looks like, just for beat size.
I will click this. My god. That was a PlayStation 2 game, you said.
No. This is a Saturn game.
Okay. That's slightly better, but, like, it's not great.
I would almost say it's worse, because it should be, like, a 2D powerhouse, and it looks like this.
That's true. Like, you know, if you're doing stuff on the Saturn, it should be, like, you know, fucking killing it. This is not killing it.
Last night I was giving a poor unfortunate soul a fucking college course on fucking works of Climax and started rambling about Dark Savior for 20 solid minutes. Dark Savior is crazy. Everyone should at least gaze at Dark Savior at least once in their life. Do you know Dark Savior, Bob?
I do not.
It was a game that looks like it maybe started life as a Landstalker sequel. And then...
You have my interest?
Someone got real weird. So Dark Savior has five storylines, and the determinant factor of which one you will be doing is how well you do in the first 20 minutes of the game.
Interesting.
Because there's like a timed mission, like 10 minutes in, you have 4 minutes to get to the captain's room of this of the ship you're on and defend them from the monster that's trying to kill them. And if you are too late, then you get there and they're already dead, and you go down a scenario where you just keep following this monster as it leaves a wake of dead bodies in its path. And if you're the right, if you get there fast but not too fast, you manage to fight off the monster, and it takes you to a different story entirely that doesn't, it doesn't even make sense quite how it manages to do that. And then in the third, if you get there really fast, you bar the monster out of the captain's room before it even gets in, and that takes you to yet another story path. Then there's like another, the when you finish that story path, it unlocks a fourth story path that is about the parallel universes that caused all these story paths beginning to collapse in on themselves. And then there's a secret fifth story path where if you get, if you're on this path to story path two and you're fighting the monster and you fucking die, you get a fifth story path where you are where you are in purgatory and fighting for the chance to be brought back to life.
I'm sorry, I'm trying to play solve a puzzle right now and you just made me dumber. Like, I really thought I had this, and now I can't.
What game Dark is this Savior game? Sucks, but it owns. What?
Dark Savior. I see.
Yeah.
I see.
Dark Savior sucks, but it owns. Also, all fights in the game are done like a fucking fighting game for some reason, but it's still an isometric, like, platformer-looking construction. It's just that when you get into a fight, it's like, round one, start, and then you play with really bad fighting game controls. It's extremely weird and extremely ambitious in all the stupidest ways. Mm. And no one should play it, but everyone should at least experience some portion of it. Tune in next week for the next exciting Climax Entertainment Group lecture about how yogurt is the most important character ever devised.
Yogurt?
Yogurts. Why do I...
Training course. Don't you know yogurt?
I do not know.
Okay,
he's
I'm going to...
mascot character.
Yeah, he's incredible. I'm going to send you a picture of him. You're going to have to live with yogurt. He is.
Don't
he is
feel like
love
I deserve
and joy.
That.
No, he is love and joy. He will love yogurt as we all love yogurt. Put him in general because everyone should see yogurt.
Thank you. Thank you for spreading the pain around.
Yogurt is. Have you seen him yet, Abby?
No. I'm doing something okay. Secrets.
Oh no!
I'm buying your fucking birthday present. Happy birthday.
Oh, thank you. You're very sweet.
Wait, is it? I know it's 20 something. Was it today?
It's the 29th. It's on Friday. But don't worry about it.
Don't worry about it.
What I was going to say was yogurt is incredible because yogurt is an active detriment to any battle he is in. He is. Level 1, he has 1 in every stat. He will only ever gain 1 experience point for participating in combat. It takes 100 experience points for anyone to level up. Yogurt, when he levels up, will not actually gain a level. It will say he leveled up, and his level will stay 1.
Well, that's
yogurt
cool.
Cannot change, yogurt cannot change class. If you try to promote him, he will promote from yogurt to yogurt and stay there. You can promote him infinitely.
But he never changes, like.
Yeah, so you can just keep using the promote command. And okay, you can keep doing
it. Beautiful.
You'll stay a yogurt.
All right, I am now prepared. I've steeled my soul. I'm ready to look at yogurt. My God. That is one of those moles from Mario Bros. Wearing a Star Wars hat. That's very impressive.
If you somehow manage to kill something with yogurt, it will drop a yogurt ring. The only thing the yogurt ring does is it makes anyone wearing it look and have the stats of yogurt.
How is this real?
I assume his stats are not very good.
His stats are all ones.
Oh my. You know what? I appreciate that kind of in-depth like mechanics joke.
Like everything about yogurt was like very thoughtfully designed to make him useless as a combat. But you can still talk to yogurt. You can still invite yogurt into your heart, even if you do not send him into battle.
Wait, was there a link to look at yogurt?
It's in general.
It's in general.
The sound of seeing yogurt.
Yogurt is a precious idiot.
I feel like yogurt, the best like modern version we have of yogurt, are the Animal Crossing characters. So many people, like when they get them, just like scream fire and damnation to the heavens because this fucking idiot gerbil is preventing them from getting the cat thirst trap.
God, that reminds me. Fucking like the Nintendo tweet, it's like, oh, it's this character's birthday, and then like the follow-up tweet, please be
people getting angry at him.
Yeah, no, they hate certain hamsters are just widely despised by the Animal Crossing geeks.
Certain hamsters. Is there anything else I can use to block that? I'm having a dampest time with this puzzle.
Honestly, I feel bad for those hamsters. They didn't do anything wrong. They didn't ask to be born into a world that despised them. Also, like, let's be real. Raymond absolutely listens to Ben Shapiro and thinks he has very interesting ideas.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, okay, now I get it.
Also, if you take the time to talk to Yogurt, he basically just talks about his helmet. He's very proud of it.
His helmet, did you say?
His helmet.
Nice.
Yogurt is a special boy. And I mean that in the most H-Wood sense possible.
Here comes a special boy.
Here lies Philippe. Oh, man. I can't remember. To remember what that fucking fake newspaper like thing in Philippe's mind says.
Okay, now what am I supposed to do with this?
I believe you'll figure it out. Figure it out at all.
I am disappointed in your having said that.
Did you, like, Gogglebob, we've been friends for how many years? You should have seen this one coming.
Like, I mean, that's true.
He's disappointed, gonna, like, but not surprised.
Yes.
Like, there are certain, like, patterns you really should have picked up on by
disappointed
now.
Disappointed but not surprised is the exact proper explanation here. Alright, so I can shoot that laser off in any direction. But I want the laser to be activating the thing, because that allows me to press the button. So I presume the prism can split the laser? Like, that makes the most sense. I only get one chance at a portal. Well, this is too tough for me. I'm gonna put it here. No, it doesn't. Wait, I'm gonna get it. No, it doesn't. What am I supposed to do here? Laser goes somewhere. Anybody got any tips?
Yeah, I'm looking it up.
Book Space Camp Pervert.
No.
Do it.
No. We are not doing what we do.
Space Camp 7, I got to two. Tell me where we do.
Just chilling with the space camp crew, just doing what we do. Yeah, we're stopping there.
Yeah, we're stopping there. We're making poor decisions, but it's never too late. Always a good time to stop making poor decisions.
Prism. Like, I can make it. Oh, and then. Okay, that makes sense. I think I got this.
Well, yeah.
Okay, that makes sense. Don't have to do this simultaneously.
I think you could, though. I think you should.
Okay. Yeah, you got it.
Solutions to problems.
Oh, you just solved it, didn't you? I told you to tell you. Why are you making this so hard for me?
Yeah, see, I was thinking that things had to be solved simultaneously, but that's stupid.
You're overthinking a Wheatley puzzle.
Exactly. I was overthinking a Wheatley puzzle. I feel like that is some sort of our code for today. Never overthink a Wheatley puzzle.
Was self-destructing, already fixed. Programmed in one last tremor for old time's sake. One or two more tremors in there, just for fun.
Warning. Core overheating.
I let him keep his job. I'm not a monster. Ignore what he's saying, but just keep on testing.
Now my patron copter stuck in my head. You did this to me, fanboy. I don't know how you did it, but you did this somehow.
Patron copter.
Well, I did start saying that, so I do know how it is.
Yeah, but like, you were like really quiet. It was barely under your breath, but it was enough. It was exactly enough.
Fucking death clock. Pickle's rehab song / Sky Hunters is perhaps the greatest rock opera ever written. Yeah, I said it. I don't give a fuck.
I still think my favorite thing about the Hatred Counter song is just that it's mostly about not knowing how to pilot the damn thing.
Yeah, like, his entire thing is he has no idea how to fly a helicopter and is just not doing great.
I'm gonna get fired for not being able to pilot the Hatred Counter.
It's like, oh, this is going badly.
This could have gone a lot better.
This could have gone a lot better. Could have gone worse, but it could have gone better.
Okay. can't seem to find the button that turns the radar on. It can't work the hatred copter the hunter you was on.
Hatred copter.
Hatred copter.
Okay, I got it.
I could fight for my baby to fly, but I'll be fine when I'm killing you, because that's my job. Hatred copter.
That thought was better than we deserved.
Oh, 100%. Wasn't that one of the ones they were threatening to do a movie of? That was the one that made sense.
They sort of did a movie because the Doomstar Requiem is basically a movie.
Basically.
Yeah, but I mean, like, they were threatening a revival movie. I
know they were threatening an Aqua Teen revival
movie.
Like,
no, the Aqua Teen revival movie we know has happened.
Which seems bad because, like, the Aqua Teen.
The movie film for theaters just is like. There's probably, like, two or three good episodes in it, and then it's like.
It's a miracle that it exists, and I'm very glad I saw it with exactly six stoned guys.
That's the proper number.
Who I did not know. I just walked into the theater, and there were, like, six guys who were very obviously.
Yeah, I'm shocked that you would go into a movie film for theaters showing, and it's just nothing but stone dudes.
But, like, you know, that was a once-in-a-lifetime experience I'm very glad I had. That said, it is perhaps, like, when I want to watch some Aqua Teen, I just put on any random episode on HBO Max. I do not go straight to the movie. In fact, I don't think it's even on HBO Max.
Is it? That
sucks.
Oh, the
movie? I don't think so, no.
No, it's not. That's strange.
That is. That's annoying.
Yeah, because, like,
I'd
you
also
know,
like to point out that, yes, there is a Metal Apocalypse movie happening, and there's going to be a new album to go with it, apparently.
Nice.
Yeah, it's going to be awesome.
Come to think of it, nobody's been in the chat all day.
Well, Beat never retweeted the thing, so.
Oh, I blame Beat.
I'm in crunch mode right now, guys.
I don't blame you. It's just one of those things where it's by now and.
Gotta accept that, like, I have other priorities at the moment.
The only reason I have an audience is Beat talking about it. I see how it is.
But it is the big reason because I'm so cool and popular. I'm a kingmaker. A tastemaker. I make tasty treats. People love my baguettes.
I feel like there's a phrase that maybe we should never hear again, but I'm going to allow it.
Yeah.
Weird, but okay.
Even though I don't think an Aqua Teen movie makes sense.
I really don't. Like I said, like the best Aqua Teen episodes are just episodes. The movie is like a weird experiment that, like, I love that.
And
it
you stretch these plots out, and the answer is kind of no.
But, like, the perfect length for anything Aqua Teen is 11 minutes.
There's not really, like, a way to make it, like, 22 minutes sometimes works if they're being very silly about how there, like, is no sense.
Yeah, like, 22 minutes worked in the, like, fake finale. Because they went all in on, like, pretending that this was, like, a serious and, like, stone-faced event. And then the very next week, they, last week. And did a different finale. That was just them all fucking around, like they always do.
That's how they end the series.
They probably could have done that, like, with Last Dance for Napkin Lad, which is hilarious. Because it, like, refuses to break, like, kayfabe at any point.
Yeah, no, 100%.
But, like, I don't see a movie-length Aqua Teen as something that, like, I would want to watch. At the very least, not in one sitting. I would split that out across multiple days.
Still love the, like, when they started doing, like, the different titles for every season, and the first time we're going to try to make them detectives again. It's going to be go back to its roots, and then it was just the exact same goddamn thing.
It's the exact same thing, but every single episode started with like a little like line of text at the bottom of the screen that said Seattle.
Yeah, instead of New Jersey.
It was still New Jersey, but like they were telling you it was Seattle.
Looks so much like Seattle. Truly, they were an Aqua Teen hunger force.
Your parking brake's on!
I gotta drive, jackass.
Like, I think weirdly the best, like, proof that Aqua Teen works perfectly in small doses is the fact that, like, the little tiny, like, shorts they did on YouTube. Presumably to promote the, like, eventual movie.
Yeah.
Are fucking hysterical and perfect.
Oh, yeah, no, they're all perfect.
And all of them are, like, 3 minutes max. Like, Aqua Teen knows how to, like, do a lot with very little, but, like, when they're given a lot, I think they just sort of flounder. I will watch the movie.
Oh, yeah, no, I'm gonna watch it.
I would watch it all in one sitting, which is not something I even did for the Snyder Cut. But And really, like, you should watch the Snyder Cut in one sitting. It's a mini-series that, like, was a movie somehow.
It was even split into, like, five parts.
It is literally split into parts, and, like, while watching it, I'm like, huh, so, like, this is the Aquaman episode, and that was the Batman episode. This is a mini-series.
I don't even think that was necessarily a bad idea.
No, it wouldn't be. It would be a movie. Would be a fine idea. Like, I honestly think that would have been a pretty cool idea. Like, I don't see that going wrong.
Oh, yeah. But yeah, no, I'll definitely watch it. I'm not gonna pretend I'm not gonna watch it. Aqua Teen is baked into my brain forever.
Oh, same. Big same.
Aqua Teen will never be canceled.
I love that, like, they made that the theme song for the very last season.
When they knew they had been canceled.
Yeah. Just, like, a last act of, like, pure defiance.
I did appreciate that there was a period, like, apparently before they settled on that name after Aqua Teen Under Force Forever, after realizing they'd been canceled. Apparently, before that, they were angling for the title Aqua Tebow Avoidance Plan.
I think my DVR just, like, lists all, like, the seasons as just Aqua Teen.
Oh, it wouldn't surprise me if that's how it was done.
Tebow.
Remember Tebow?
Yeah.
Remember when another company ate Tebow and renamed itself Tebow because its current name was too toxic?
That's happened a lot of times.
Yeah.
Way more than I care to count. There's actually a term for it. It's called the reverse merger, where, like, you bought something, but you bought them so you could have their, like, untainted name because your name.
You literally just bought their face to wear on.
Yeah. You bought their face so you could wear, like, a skin suit.
Yeah.
Which is very Hannibal Lecter, which is a good analogy for, Perfect World. Edward's still
dead. Oh, I did find something, though. Reminds me, I've got a big surprise for you two. Seriously, look forward to it.
I won't say the name of the company, but if you know me, you probably already know it. But that happened to, like, where my dad worked when I was a kid. And I remembered reading about it, like, in fucking Time magazine. Like, parents had a subscription to that or something, and I just read it, like, when I was bored. And they mentioned my dad's company, and they called it a name change. And I was like, man, they did, like, you know, buy something. They didn't just say, oh, we're this now. They didn't just change their name. That offended me. That offended a 12-year-old me. I was 13.
Your dad, who worked for Murder Knife Co.
No, he was in the company that got bought because they had not been tainted yet.
They got bought by Murder Knife Co.
They got bought by Murder Knife Co. Sammy Stabbington's fine pointy implements LLC.
Fine Pokeballs.
Oh, I like that. That's a way better name than what I said. Fine Pokeballs.
Listen, we just need to workshop each other. It's fine.
Like, this is what workshopping is for. It's all good. No bad ideas.
Yes, you, the idiot. Bad idea. That is also from Aqua Teen.
Yep.
There are no dumb questions. Yes, you, the idiot with the dumb questions.
Because I can only go to one place.
The episode where that ends with her just arbitrarily saying, oh, I just wanted to be an actor.
You have to get a box, Bob.
Fucking cowboy movie.
I want to get a box.
Ooh, I'm a real cowboy. Love spreading all day long. Emptying my tanks on you while I sing my song.
I'm learning.
I swear, I search for words chemtrail cowboy like once every 2 years or so, and it's still up some fucking how. Channel's long dead, but some things remain.
Someday they never come.
Just like the most vocorded, why yes, I do believe in evil of government chemicals shit ever. And that's not to say that the government would not absolutely drown you in like fucking like in whatever, like just to save a buck. But like in fucking hairline engines, those are a mile up in the air. If they wanted to kill you, there's like 8 faster ways to do it.
Sigh.
Okay, sigh.
I can do that. Eat. Oh, I guess I need to bring my box here. A box can go elsewhere.
Boxathon?
Boxington. Foxy Brown. did we just both say that simultaneously?
Yes. It was the inevitable.
You knew it was coming. Alright, so now...
That's 2 years, that's it.
What's that?
No, I'm searching. I'm investigating.
Oh, yeah.
It's not coming up, but it's entirely possible that other things have just sort of taken its place in the algorithm. I'm not convinced it does not, it no longer exists.
Chemtrail Cowboy exists in your heart, if nowhere else.
I mean, yeah, like, and also, like, Googling this gets me, like, you know, the, hey, you're aware you're searching misinformation. Yeah, dumbass. Why do you think I'm looking for the words chemtrail?
I was going to say, the word chemtrail just does it, doesn't it?
Yeah.
Oh, that didn't work as I wanted it to. I feel like there should be a more instant death thing going on here. All right.
That's your call.
Somehow Joe Rogan showed up in this fucking, like, YouTube search, which solidifies what Raider said about him, which is that he has never told a lie in his life, and I believe that.
Honestly, he believes all of that stupid shit.
Yeah, no, like, if you tell Joe Rogan that's something, terrible. He just goes, wow, really? Whoa! That's just the way his brain works.
Yeah, I am still amazed that is the guy from News Radio. Like, there's something about
somehow
that breaks my brain.
Just no wonder it's no Andy longer. Dick is not the worst person on News Radio.
Exactly.
I mean, like, just think about Joe Rogan. I don't think he has ever thought terribly hard about anything. I think that if you tell him something, he just believes it without question. I don't think he is necessarily dumb, but I do think that he is very willing to just, you know, accept whatever you tell him.
I mean, at some point, like, the material difference between being dumb and that kind of parrot mind is not honestly...
Yeah, no, there's just no difference. There are occasions when he is pushed back, like when he goes, when his brain remembers, wait a second.
Words have meaning.
Something different. The last time, what's going on here? But they are few and far between.
Yeah.
Okay, now what am I supposed to do to not die here?
Yeah, I can't find it. It might no longer exist. I'm going to search the lyrics now.
Gotta need my box back.
Gotta be somewhere. Put it in quotation marks. We're fucking like using the advanced search tech now. No results for it. Shit, I'm sure it had the lyrics in the description. I think it might be gone. The end of an era.
R.I.P. Chemtrail.
I mean, fucking Lana Del Rey made apparently a song called Chemtrails Over the Country Club, so that I'm sure. I had exactly like one person, one mutual who was super obsessed with Lana Del Rey and was like constantly like retweeting people, like, you know, stanning her and shit. And I'm just like, who is this lady? Some singer? Okay, sure. Don't get me wrong, it's cool you have favorites, but like, I don't write like every second tweet about Rancid.
You could though.
Wait, no, it's here! I found it! It's a mirror, I believe. I don't think this is definitely not the original. Yeah, this is definitely not the original, but it still exists on the internet. Now, you all get to share blurry experience with me.
What does this do for me? Like, why did I try to get here again?
Is there something above the field?
No. Over there. Wait, no.
What if you put the high paint gel?
I mean, that's what I was thinking, but I was trying to figure out why I would do that. Because I can do this, but that doesn't do much for me. I can even shoot over there if I want to. But then, of course, I think I have an idea. But that would kill me. Let's just see what happens. Okay, but then I can't go through that because of the way that works. Oh, so now, yeah, okay, now I got it. So now I won't die.
Yep, you got it.
Whee! Fuck you!
You're gonna love this picture.
Missed it by that much. Okay, take two.
Hope it saved.
It did, kinda.
Three hut, old dirty bastard, live and uncut.
Oh, lordy.
It's not too bad. I can get back to where we need to be pretty quick.
You gonna beat the game tonight, Gobob?
I'm hoping.
We'll see how that goes.
See how that works.
Like, there can't be that much left next week if I don't.
Is there anything I want to do next week? I don't believe so, no.
Yeah, does anybody have anything they want to play? I mean, Portal was kind of randomly chosen anyway. I mean, it was literally randomly chosen.
Gex.
I think I do have a Gex game myself.
Well, play Gex 3, Deep Cover Gecko.
Okay, now we got that. Now...
there's a Gex aficionado.
Okay, so... we'll do it as close to that as possible. And then, oh, I have to get my box back. My box boy.
Box boy?
Box boy.
Box boy in box room? Big day out?
I mean, any day they go out is a big day, really. I mean, they're boxes.
Rude.
Let's just be honest about what's happening there. Okay, that's as close as it gets. Hopefully this doesn't kill me this time.
Save.
Hey, it beats playing Smash Brothers.
Oh, I wonder.
You're going to love it.
Oh, thank goodness you made it this time.
Yes. Love it. Again, you'd think they would have modified slightly the whole death thing. Like, it doesn't quite need to be loading the whole room in there.
And yet.
That requires effort.
Like, everything about, with the exception of death, everything about Portal 2 is very carefully calibrated, so you, like, can't put yourself into a bad position wherein, like, you know, the box is no longer spawning or that kind of thing. Butterfinger.
Only three more chambers to your big surprise. Oh,
don't want to die. My depth perception is always bad. That's better.
So how goes the adventures of Wheatley being Wheatley?
I don't know how Smash Brothers beat.
I'm not playing Smash Brothers. I did, however, just update my Switch so I could use the new SD card I got.
Oh, nice.
Yeah, it's like 500-something gigs, which is a lot.
Yeah, that's probably funny.
More than I'll need by a significant chunk, I think.
You say that now.
I was about to say, I've never run out of that.
Sure, but like... you know, the ones that like were a terabyte were just like, that's.
In a couple of years, they'll be cheap, and by then.
Yeah, like in a couple of years, they'll be cheap, and I'll get one of them. No big deal. Plus, there'll probably be some other thing that's not a Switch in a couple of years. So whatever.
The Switch 2, the Switch.
Maybe it'll actually like have. Maybe it'll actually have, you know, like actual storage on itself. Haha, just kidding.
I do not think so. But nice, honestly, I kind of prefer just using the SD cards.
Yeah, no, it's just...
yeah.
Sweet. Alright, so... I don't even know where to begin here without getting shot. Let's see here.
Bob, turn to your left. See across the gap there? That white wall?
Yes.
That's put the portal there.
No. That's fun. Yeah.
Yeah, I'll put a pole on the floor.
Yeah, I get there. All right. Oh, okay. So there's a thing.
You're gonna
here.
Die.
lean to your left.
Okay, so now I can do this. Why did I do that? Thought I... think I got the brain problems tonight. Okay. Float along, little... whatever we call it things. Float along. Now don't. No, stop. Okay, so that just hits a wall. Could have shot that anywhere, and I didn't. Now I know
better. Yeah, you're gonna want to drop some on that ground that's here in front of you.
I get that.
I see you've reached the now let's ferry around goo forever section of the game.
Yep.
We're just gonna keep saying you goo all right. Night.
Is there a better word for it? I'm open to suggestions.
Gel.
Yes, gel.
All right. There. Sure, gel, fine.
I mean, we've got shell, we've got gel. It all makes sense.
I get that.
Hey, wait a minute, how do I get back?
You gotta put it out on the ground there, right where you're standing.
I found out this morning something cool. Primal Season 2 has started.
Yes, I saw that. I was wondering why you hadn't mentioned it.
I just now found out this morning, so not just now, but
oh, I get it. Yeah. Okay, I understand what you said.
But yeah, it is extremely cool.
Yeah, I'm into that. Oh yeah, that's something kind of fascinating that happened. And animatic for
Gendy Popeye's
Popeye movie leaked.
Oh, a new one? A different one?
So like
the whole damn movie,
like a Popeye movie keeps working, but never.
Yeah, I remember that. I remember that. Yeah.
An animatic for it leaked, which is fascinating. It seems to have like some sort of scratch track or something for the soundtrack as well.
Bob, you're gonna need gel.
Yeah, I realize that now. Alright, so I want the gel to be, like, over... Okay, so then... Does that hit a wall? Yeah, it is the wall. So I want the gel to come out... Where do I want the gel to come out? Where do I want to...
Right, so I wasn't lying when I said I wasn't playing Smash Bros., but I did get Live Alive this week, and I am looking at it. And... Huh. I have mixed thoughts on the art. When I saw the trailer, I was like, fuck yeah, it looks fucking awesome. But seeing it now, I have slightly mixed thoughts. I feel like the backgrounds are not pixely enough.
What'd you say,
I was gonna ask, like, what are the mixed thoughts coming from?
Mostly just the backgrounds. They look very high quality, or you know, just regular quality. But they don't look like something that matches with the extremely extended sprites.
Use the gel.
I know what I'm supposed to do. I just need to give me a second.
Genie is suffering watching this.
Give me a second.
Believe in you, Goggle Bob.
I got 2 out of 3.
Well, don't feel sad. 2 out of 3 ain't bad.
Heyo!
Rip in peace, Meatloaf.
Aww.
Shame he was sad.
I would do anything for love, but I won't get
anti-vax.
That.
Yeah.
Yeah, no, it's just a shame.
Yeah.
Such a fucking shame.
Yeah, I love how, like, there were definitely people commenting that, like, oh, this will COVID will become a big thing when, like, you know, our first celebrity dies, and we just learned that they don't admit that when that happens.
I mean, it was news. Like, we all knew that he died of COVID.
Did we, though?
We just decided not to care.
And, like, the meatloaf was and the celebrity was meatloaf. Like, not to disrespect a whole bunch of incredible tracks written by Jim Steinman, but, you know...
There's never going to be world-shattering.
Yeah. Like, most people were like, wait, meatloaf was still alive until recently?
Yeah, I mean, not somebody who we ever thought was the healthiest guy around.
He was named Meatloaf.
Well, that was just a stage name, but yeah.
I did see him in concert, and he did fucking kill it. Like, you know,
like that was just a stage name. He was a guy who could convincingly be called Meatloaf.
Yeah,
you're
like,
going
you
better
know,
than I when you said
like
that.
Like, you look at Meatloaf, and you're like, oh, yeah, that's a Meatloaf. there's a dude named Meatloaf.
I believe in Japan, the first noted celebrity death from COVID was the beloved star of JJ and Jeff. That's a joke for no one but me.
I was about to say.
Stars of the famous TurboGrafx 16 game?
Yes. So the TurboGrafx 16 game, JJ and Jeff, is based off of a Japanese game called Kato and Ken. Based off of a TV comedy-like variety show called Fun TV with Kato and Ken. And I think, I can't remember if it was Ken or Kato that died. I think it was Ken. Died in early 2020. Yeah, probably is.
Just got a portal jump through that portal there, Bob, and onto the blue paint.
Oh, is that what we're doing? Oh, yeah, that makes sense.
Yep, Ken Shimada. Let's see.
Right, I'm taking a break from my work to fuck around with Live Alive a little bit. I feel like they could have done a lot to make the backgrounds mesh with the foregrounds better. I feel like
that was a stylistic choice to not do that, though.
Oh, no, I get it. Like, and I'm betting the what I'm looking at right now. If you, like, looked at, like, the Emma screenshot of the area I'm in, you would be like, ah, yes, those rocks are in all the exact same places. Because, you know, they weren't trying to, like, make pixel art when they were making an SNES game. They were trying to make, you know, something that looked like rocks.
Especially given that they had spent a great deal of money hiring a bunch of manga artists to design more characters.
Yeah. Wait, they did that with Live Alive? I thought they just did that with Chrono Trigger.
No, Chrono Trigger is just Toriyama. Live Alive is like 7 different manga artists.
Huh, I did not know that. Any names I would be familiar with?
I don't think so. A lot of them do not have a lot of presence in English. The one that I knew the most was Gosho Aoyama, who did the Detective Conan manga.
Okay, that's a name. Let me guess, he designed the robot. I just look at that robot and look at Conan and think, yeah, no, it was the same guy.
Let me double check. See.
Also, I just genuinely love the fact that, like, the plot of Detective Conan is that, like, he was 17 and then he got, like, poisoned and it turned him into a 7-year-old. Or, like, a 10-year-old. And that meant his girlfriend was, like, you know, 7 years older than him. And the show has been going long enough for them to have gotten married, like, at, you know, in their 20s. And,
they can just ignore that problem.
Yeah, like, at that like, we are at the point where it has been running in real time long enough for that to no longer be an issue.
Yeah, because, like, the thing about Detective Conan was that it was always just an excuse to write mysteries.
Yeah, no. And you know what?
Yeah, for the most part.
Wait, so is he still a 7-year player?
There has been no real time aging one.
Yeah. It's running on a sliding scale time. He did literally everything he did in the last 20 years in 1 month.
You're like, this is the part where he kills her.
It was a chapter title.
And the achievement.
Title drop. None of you guys care, but the latest One Punch Man chapter is extremely good. Like, all those, I had fears about where the story was going. They were all of them have been banished. All of them are just gone. Like, there is literally no part of me that is even remotely working.
Yay!
They just wanted to do some cool shit before they did the actual, like, important, like, ending. And it was extremely cool shit, so no complaints.
One other thing that I was trying to say about the new Live Alive is that the game's original director was also brought on as, like, producer, so...
Oh, that's cool.
Yeah, like, my complaints about the way it looked were just very much a momentary adjustment thing, and the second I had a moment to, like, you know, rethink, I was back.
Can I just say, as somebody who's, like, been working for their entire adult life, if you brought me back to work on a project I'd worked 20 years prior, I'd be like, oh, wait, what? Yeah, that was something I was doing.
Like, currently, I assume it's slightly different for, like, creatives.
I hope so.
Yeah, for him, it's, like, apparently, like, it's partly just... enjoyable because it's like, I think it's the first game that Tokita actually directed, and it was generally considered a failure at the time. So for him, that's probably at least like, oh, at least, you know, at least it found an audience.
I remember when I found out about it, I was like, yo, this is the coolest shit ever.
Yeah, the avowed reason that we didn't get it is because it didn't do well in Japan.
Yeah. But, like, there is a very good, like, translation patch for the SNES version. I've played it.
Yeah.
Yeah, that was definitely one of those I kept meaning to get around to, and then guess what?
Yeah. The official translation, apparently... references departed emulator author Nier.
Really?
Yeah. R.I.P.
Rest in peace.
Anyway, new turret, not defective.
I think you can portal into that room there, Bob.
Yeah, and I'm gonna get in there.
Bob did not come here to learn.
Portal in, but where do I start?
Probably on the other side.
That's what I was guessing. Oh, give me a home. Okay, wait, maybe I can push things.
Just not that long ago, I learned that this is just more stupid bullshit video game trivia. Feel free to ignore them. I just not that long ago learned that the developers of the first couple Arc Alive games were the creators of the Front Mission franchise.
Really?
Ah.
Yeah.
Would not have guessed that, but then again, I can kind of see
it. It makes sense in retrospect.
Yeah, it's like, hmm.
I can explain.
My favorite kind of realization is like one where you think about it for a second, you're like, actually, I'm kind of surprised I didn't already know
that. Yeah, no, I can kind of see it.
It's it's like when I found out that the writer of Trigun was Roman Catholic, I was like, huh, that's surprising. Wait, that's
that is in no way surprising, yes.
That is absolutely unsurprising.
Like,
there's nothing surprising.
Like, the writer of Daredevil is Catholic. Well, I guess Frank Miller in this case, but...
Like, oh, yeah, the writer of the box art is Catholic. No, really? You think? It literally... The boxer literally ends with a boxer named Jay taking all the pain of a boxer named you. Doesn't get more on the nose than that.
Who could it be?
Large impact.
And it's still really fucking good. It's a fucking fantastic
subtlety is
ending.
Overrated.
No, like, it's...
For cowards.
It is just screaming, fuck subtext. All my homies hate subtext.
Subtext is, like... Being unsubtle is only a problem when what you're saying isn't interesting enough.
Yeah.
Holmes versus Moriarty. Aristotle.
Now, what am I supposed to... Oh. There.
Stay still, please. All right, stop moving.
He can't take conspiracy.
Fast boy.
And see, now it's at least game appropriate. As I'm racing through the corridors.
Fast.
Love that Speed Racer is one of those anime that really only happened. Like, it was not based, like, it was based on a manga. It was not a particularly popular manga. It's just that the person who wrote it happened to be a big wig at Tatsunoko.
I'll be back if you're still alive.
I am going to get money off of this.
I'm going to profit off this even if it kills all of you.
I think he died pretty young though, sadly.
That's fucked. Shame.
Is Speed Racer like another Voltron where it became more popular in the States than anywhere else?
Oh yeah, no. It was very much a...
Damn it.
The States cared about it more than Japan. Amazing
if it, and half the reason the States cared about it was because it came off so poorly here.
I can't imagine why the series about a guy with a really cool car dressed in wet, bright blue dwell in America.
Oh, Japan had initial D.
But was he dressed like an American flag?
It's true, he was not.
I am just going to kill myself repeatedly here.
We've all been there.
I keep thinking I'm going to make it.
You keep jumping at a really conservative place.
I'm afraid of being slowed down by the slickness.
How are you gonna... What? Run that back.
Gosh damn it! I thought I did good that time.
Run it back. Tell us what you said again. Describe your logic.
Friction. Okay, let's give this another go.
Did something break back there? Oh, did it kill you? That would be amazing if it killed you.
No, that's not. No.
Hello? Oh, yes, Lord, no, just had a brainwave.
Oh, I forgot it works like that. Okay. Okay, this time I'm gonna get it.
This time will be different.
It's not different at all, is it, Steve?
Nope. You were gonna do this.
Did something break back there?
There we go. See, I thought I had to bounce off of it as opposed to just jump from it.
Yeah, no, just jumping off it.
Yeah, okay. Better now. This is what happens when you wait a week to come back.
You're Wheatleying it out there.
Yeah. It's hard not to Wheatley on stream.
Bob is Wheatley and all of us are GLaDOS.
Bunch of potatoes.
On a long enough timeline. All of us Wheatley from the first to the last.
I've lived long enough to see myself become a Wheatley.
There's a spot on the wall there to your right, Bob. About behind you now.
Oh yeah, there it is.
My go go.
This could end poorly.
You could end poorly. For all
so
we know.
So you say. But maybe. Just thinking. Maybe it'll be really cool. Everything will be great. You don't know.
I mean, you're not wrong. Oh, not certain if this is a good idea or not. Oh yeah, it wasn't a good idea.
Yeah, there's a spot on the ceiling.
Yeah, I was gonna say I need to go a little bit different.
Alright, staring at the ceiling.
At least this time, I know how to make the jump.
Something bright back there.
Freaking Super Mario here.
Oh, did it kill you? That would be amazing if it killed you. Hello? Yes, more. No, just had a brainwave. I'll be back. If you're still alive, I'm gonna be back. Don't die until I get back.
I do like when you're using unconventional weapons.
My favorite weapons are the unconventional ones. Convention. Shut up, fuck you. We all know my brain works about as well as the rest of me.
What
the rest
about.
Of me work pretty well.
Yeah, you're a good worker.
Yeah.
Get back there easily, or what am I supposed to do? Go over there. Yay. I'm over here and I'm not being gunned down. Hooray.
Sounds upsettingly optimistic. I'm not saying you're dead, but
I already swallowed my USB drive. I'm prepared to be gunned down.
Oh man, God, I just keep thinking about her fucking like, oh, but if you make an NFT of it, no assets are lost. Like, God, that is only something that can be said by somebody who is so entrenched in money, but not in what money means. Everything in their life is one step removed from anything anybody would do, like, you know, normally.
I just want to say that if I had stolen someone's diamond and found out they also had an NFT of it, I would absolutely steal the NFT.
I mean, it wouldn't even be hard. They got like...
Oh no, it would be super easy.
They got like fucking script kiddies for that shit. All you have to do is like contact them and honestly, say, hey, I would like to trade you your diamond for a lot, but let's not pay.
They'll trade you a diamond for this board that I also stole.
Let's just give each other access to our wallets and then take it. Because that's how like most of them get stolen. Somebody says, oh yeah, hey, do you hate paying $50 anytime you do anything on OpenSea? So do I. That's all it takes, apparently. It's so fucking easy. Actually upsetting.
The tragic truth of all confidence schemes, they all kind of rely on someone thinking that they're the ones putting something over on someone.
It's true.
Think like, there's so many things about crypto that blow my fucking mind, but I think the one that continually shocks me is that because pump and dumps are technically not illegal in crypto, they're illegal with literally every other financial system, but they are not illegal in crypto yet because nobody has thought to make them illegal yet. You get people bragging about how they're going to do a pump and dump.
Yeah, they just notably state it's going to happen.
No one regulates this shit because none of it matters.
I saw a promoted tweet saying, get ready for the pump of the century, and I'm like, you are literally... not only just posting about committing a financial crime,
the century.
But you paid money for me to see you post about a financial crime. Fuck is wrong with you?
A lot. Where do we start?
So much more than we could possibly list. We would be here all fucking day. God, promoted tweets are wonderful because, like, most of the time it's just like, oh, hey, have you heard of Ford trucks? And I'm like, yes, I have heard of four trucks. I understand they are still
perfectly
acceptable trucks. Now we'll never hear of four trucks again. But every once in a while, you get some jackass who thinks they're smart, trying to demonstrate how smart they are. And somehow, every time they do it, they post the dumbest shit imaginable, and then pay actual money to get you to see the shit, and so you can laugh at them.
I can explain some causation there. The kind of person who's ready to tweet the dumb shit imaginable is the kind of person ready to pay money to Twitter to show it to people.
Every time it happens, I'm just like, wow, you really thought you were dumb here, did you? Holy shit, it's amazing, it's a miracle. I'm so happy that you are the exact kind of dumb to think that. You are the exact kind of dumb where you still think you're smart. Like, a lot of people are exactly smart enough to know that they're dumb and therefore know how to hide it. But every once in a while, you get one that's not. That's the shit I live for.
Where you at, Gongle Bob?
I'm running into a wall.
I believe in you.
Thank you.
I mean, I just saw you run into the wall. I believe in you significantly less now.
That's disappointing.
And you blame me.
There we go. Distant explosion.
That's right. Part of Wheatley running things is that he has no idea how to, like, you know, not cause everything to melt down.
I mean, it's what you would expect to have happen. You do not want Wheatley in charge of this. And GLaDOS has learned to be a better person AI thing.
She hasn't.
Well,
you stream for so long that I am already eliminated from my tournament.
See what you've done. You've ruined this.
I am
for Cali's bro.
I am sorry. I think
great Cali's bro. Just.
What time is it?
It is
eleven for you.
Yeah, well, that's not too bad.
That's not the worst.
Damn. We've done worse.
I just got eliminated too early.
I would like to point out, however, that Goggle Bob asking what we were going to do next week is starting to feel premature.
We are close. We're already at the point where they remind us how bombs work. So, like, we're close to the end.
We're basically there. Like, you know, I actually do believe Goggle Bob will conquer, will vanquish the game tonight. I support him.
Yeah.
This
he doesn't have
noble,
that much left.
I could consider getting a sandwich so that I don't miss the finale.
You probably should do that now because, you know, it's not going to be long. I think the game, like, jerks you around a little bit at this point. Like, haha, you thought it was the end, but it's not.
Thought you were hot. Guess what? You're not.
I remember Gears of War being an offender in that specific category.
And everybody's favorite corrupted core.
Space core!
Space!
There's a star core waiting in the sky.
Here goes to the one place.
Fanboy's not here right now. I gotta
captain.
Fill in.
Space! I'll take you up. I'm just a Tim Curry now.
The one place that isn't corrupted by capitalism. Everybody likes revenge.
give okay, Elon Musk like a month or two. Let's see what fucking happens. Trying to think, but I'm bad at it. No, talking about space for some reason. You mentioned Tim Curry, and that made me think of the tweet about how literally any style of acting at works with the Muppets, because Tim Curry and Muppet Treasure Island is like, I am going to match the Muppets' weirdness. And Michael Caine in Muppet Christmas Carol was like, I am going to play this shit like it's fucking Shakespeare. And both of them worked.
Four-part plan is this. One, no portal services. Two, start the neurotoxin immediately.
Okay, yeah, you're at the final boss, actually.
You know what? This plan is so good, I'm going to give you a sporting chance and turn off the neurotoxin. I'm joking. Of course, goodbye.
Neurotoxin level at capacity in 5 minutes.
That sounded real. No, that was actually an impression of you. Because you just fell into my trap, my brilliant trap. Because I wanted you to trick me into bursting that pipe. Didn't trick me, to give you false hope. Because that leads to overconfidence. And that leads to mistakes, fatal mistakes. That's all part of the plan. I have actually made my actual first mistake by telling you my plan just now. The old Achilles heel again. Armed with that knowledge,
you can shoot portals up, Bob.
Up? What do you mean by up?
Up. Like, there's a bunch of white spots on the upper walls.
Oh, okay. Did not notice that.
I had unmuted so I could hear Wheatley monologue. And for a solid second, I thought Jeannie was just repeating herself, and I was like, what? But then I realized I was an idiot.
Do I just think we have to jump up there?
Yep.
Where do I attach it? There we go. I might die once, but I'll figure it out. System compromised. Neurotoxin
offline. Reactor explosion in. Thanks. I think you. There you go.
What have you
pawned to me? 4 minutes, Bob. That one I did well pretty quickly.
I love Space Core. Yeah, it's the stupidest name, but whatever.
Okay, I guess.
Core 2 is tough core.
Here, stand behind me. Yeah, just like that. Just like you're doing. Things are about to get real messy. You're going for yourself, huh? All right, I'll do what I can to cover you. Doesn't bother me. Gotta say that.
What the fuck?
Oh, well, die at the finish line. I'm going to kill you.
Yeah, don't worry, I can always come back. It's not that much loss. There we go.
This is like Christmas. You know, it's better than Christmas.
And I really am all, like, ridiculous.
Warning. Core corruption at 75%. Reactor explosion timer destroyed. Reactor explosion uncertainty emergency preemption protocol initiated. This facility will self-destruct in 2 minutes.
Enough! I told you not to put these cores on, but you don't listen, do you? Quietly, not listening to a word I say, judging, silent, worst kind. All I wanted to do was make everything better for me. All you had to do was to solve a couple of...
with Core. That is up there? The fuck? Am I supposed to... It's like a jumping thing. Okay, there we go. I got to...
Pretty sure you gotta fling yourself out of, like, one of the, one of the upper portals.
There's the...
There's the fast gel. You're welcome, everybody.
Friends are in the wall.
I'm very good at that.
Yeah. Like, I'd be lying if I said I expected anything else.
Core attached to Wheatley. Running into walls is what I do.
Oh, I see.
Oh, right. Fact Core. I feel like Fact Core deserves to be a bigger meme than Space Core.
Are you ready to start?
What do you think?
Interpreting vague answer as yes.
No! Pick up on my sarcasm!
Stalemate detected. Fire detected in the stalemate resolution annex. Extinguishing.
That just cleans right off, does it? Well, that would have been good to know a little earlier.
Stalemate resolution associate. Please press the stalemate resolution button.
That's how to get ripped off paint.
Yep.
Press that button.
Do I have to get up with the catwalk?
No, it's right above the button.
Oh.
I gotcha,
yeah, no, it took a minute. Once again, my biggest problem is looking at things.
People don't look up enough. This is my favorite part.
And I have no idea how to fix this place.
R5, booby trap stalemate, but.
What did we learn about how portal paint is made?
Space!
Yeah.
let go, I'm still connected. I can pull myself in. I can still fix
Beautiful.
This.
I already fixed it, and you are not coming back.
Oh no, change your plans. Hold on to me.
Sorry, Wheatley. Lunacy.
Death in space, the greatest of all deaths.
I mean, Wheatley's probably still alive.
Assuming he can't really die.
Batteries work.
Oh, thank God, you're all right.
Thank you for the tease for two-player mode.
Being Carolyn taught me a valuable lesson.
Like, I would say this is a JoJo after 10,000. Since you're finally stopped thinking moment, but that implies that Wheatley has thoughts.
Taught me an even more valuable lesson, where Carolyn lives in my brain.
Carolyn, delete.
Goodbye, Carolyn. You know, deleting Carolyn just now taught me a valuable lesson. The best solution to a problem is usually
Goodbye,
the
Carolyn.
Easiest one.
Yeah, that is just terrible.
Honest, killing you is hard.
You it's fucking icer.
Like? I just tested. Nobody murdered me, or put me in a potato, or fed me to birds.
Nobody put me in a potato.
I had a pretty good life. And then
or fed me to birds.
You dangerous, mute, lunatic. So you know what? You win. Just go. It's been fun. Don't come back.
Thank you. fanboy Mr. Finale.
Don't come back. No, I was there. I was just muted because I was chewing.
Oh, that makes sense.
See, the trick I always follow is don't mute yourself when you're chewing.
I mean, legitimately, I don't remember anyone ever, like, audibly eating on these streams, and I've been rewatching them recently, so... Good job.
Was this part where they sing?
Yes.
Okay, yes.
I got the stream here, so I don't...
Well, I mean, I haven't been shot, so it has to be.
Yeah.
And I feel like this is also another one of those...
Big chonky boy.
Yes. This was another one of those things that they used to claim, and then the king one in the background. This was another one of those things that they used to claim that Caroline was their mother, because this is apparently like a maternal opera song that they're singing or whatever. Also, now that Shell's free, has a portal gun, and knows how the moon works, do you think she, like, bounces back and forth up there? Or, like, anything she doesn't want to deal with, she just starts dropping in the moon?
Yeah, it'd be dangerous not to get sucked through it.
I feel like Shell having, like, infinite access to the moon is just a bad idea.
But she does!
Yeah, I know. No, it's not great. Not great for anyone.
I was going to say, shouldn't get long to live anyway. Moon rocks causes cancer.
Oh, yeah, that's true.
Wait, it does?
I mean, according to Cave, it does.
Fair enough. Well, here we are again. It's always such a pleasure. Remember when you tried to kill me twice? That was Portal 2, a good video game.
Yes.
Yep.
With also good credits. Under the
circumstances. Next week, Kokobo plays Norbacular Crown.
Next week, Gogglepot plays Darksiders, the first one, which had the portal gun as one of the things you can get.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Their game is just comically boring.
Yeah, that is a weird... Like, I cannot believe that the Darksiders... I mean, I never played the third one, but the first and second one set up, like... This is a world of mankind after the apocalypse. And then just, it's freaking D&D. like
it's just 90% of D&D campaigns.
But, like, why did they bother? Like, they set up this whole, like, post-apocalyptic thing, and then 90% of it is just, like, a generic fantasy land.
I mean, that's also, like, the setting for Berserk.
No, so true, yes. But Berserk has other things going on.
I mean, it's also just completely colorless in the first game, which is... Goodbye,
my only friend. I felt like the one thing the game, like, sort of had potential with...
Was that it was Zelda?
It was just basically cribbing out Zelda. It had loads of potential. But I feel like there was one, like, really interesting idea that they sort of stumbled ass backwards across, and that is there's a zombie wearing a top hat that is, like, you know, basically like final boss level straw that you can fight like four times, just shows up, right? And I always saw him and was like, huh, the zombies are basically what's left of humanity, and you are walking around what's left of humanity. Wouldn't it be interesting if the zombie had feelings on that it could articulate? Wouldn't it be like, yo, you fucking failed us, and now we're pissed off. Like, wouldn't that be a twist? But then now.
I wish I could take it all back.
Darksiders.
Yeah, Darksiders.
And not just because I'm strange.
Yeah, it does so little with the concept that, like, it's, in my opinion, it's not a bad game. It is kind of, like, workmanlike, and that, you know, you could say it's. Like,
you know what I'd say?
Boring, but, like, that's just another way to say it.
Sincerely.
but sorry, like, I don't think it's bad, but it is. Monstrous. It really doesn't do anything with this really interesting concept it sets up.
Yeah, like it's got like something that it can work with, and it just doesn't, and that's a shame. That's a real shame.
Well, on that shiny, happy note, I think we're going to call it, as Portal 2 is now ended, and Wheatley is in space, along with Space Corps. So, I think I'm going to call it. The chat has been delightfully quiet for the evening. I want to thank everybody on the stream that are probably the only people watching. And future generations that will watch this on YouTube and say, what does he mean? Nobody ever watches these things.
That's one of the most ambitious cult shots I've ever heard.
Damn.
All right.
Year 3000.
The year 2525.
When Darksiders is not alive.
3 years from now? If
Gogglebob can survive. 2525 is 500 years from now.
Good night, everybody.
Good night. Good night.